Hey everybody, Shadowblazer 3000 here. It's finally springtime, and that means the spring season is kicking off to a start. I haven't gotten to much of anything yet. I'm still trying to finish off some of my winter series. I dropped a couple, and I'm gonna try and finish out two. I need to finish Violet Evergarden and A Place Further Than the Universe. In the meantime, I figured at least I'd give one more show a try, at least try and get one spring show going here, and I can't even believe I'm watching it. It's Sword Art Online, Alternative Gun Gale Online. I got a lot of new subscribers lately, and for anyone who's new, you probably don't know, I don't like Sword Art Online. I didn't like the series, and I didn't watch anything beyond, like, maybe 7 or 8 episodes. I just couldn't. It was just not good. So why the hell am I watching the spinoff? Well, that's the good question, right? That's the $1 million question, is why am I watching a spinoff? One simple answer, I don't know. No, that's not it. But truth be told, I was a little intrigued because it is a spinoff, even though I still am not that impressed or even looking forward to it. And it's by Studio 3 Hertz, and I really liked Princess Principal, and I really liked Flip Flappers from them. They have two more works that I haven't seen. Maybe I'll try them out at some point, but I feel like there's a lot of potential here with Studio 3 Hertz. And, well, when I heard that they were announced, when I heard that they were going to be the ones animating it, I was, well, more disappointed, to be honest. It didn't make me all the more eager to jump into it. It just made me kind of disappointed because I'm like, man, what a waste. What a terrible waste to be stuck on a spinoff of Sword Art Online. I mean, what pays the bills, I get it. I can't always get it right, but if a studio is already showing to pave their way with some really great original stories, it's kind of sad that they have to get an adaptation of a spinoff of something that's not very good to begin with. I can't speak for the novel that this in turn is based off of, because I've not read it, obviously. I didn't read the original SAO novels either. And really, that's just kind of it. It's mostly the morbid curiosity to see if 3 Hertz would somehow make this better than the original. And let's get into it. Have they? Probably not, but I'll go over the first episode a bit more gritty details here. I'm not going to sum up the whole story, but basically we got two player characters, dropped into a combat tournament arena, sort of speak. Not really an arena, but first they start in the forest, then they move into a city, and they're trying to take out. This is the whole episode. It's just this one singular tournament, plus a little world-building exposition at the start to say why VR games are still all the rage, even though Sword Art Online would kill people. At least they give a decent excuse. I mean, to their credit, I get credit is due, certainly. I mean, even .hack has found the perfect excuse as to why people still play the world when it keeps putting people into comas. So, hey, there's at least one point for this. But the whole episode is just this one combat tournament. And it's these two characters, M and, I don't know how her character's supposed to be said, like, I don't know if it's supposed to be said, like, letter by letter, or it's supposed to be, like, acronym style, but, and that sounds like it'd be fine, right? I mean, this is a game, this is about a shooter game, and, right, you'd think at least it'd be exciting. To be honest, it's kind of boring. I mean, if you can believe it, even though there's plenty, it's not like there's a lack of action or anything, but it's so wordy at the same time. And we don't even really get to know who our characters are. We just see that there's this little pink girl and this big military dude. She's in pink and he's in, like, traditional army camo. And it's mostly these two. And a lot of it is just strategizing. There's plenty of action, but the action has no weight because it's already virtual anyway, but it's not very interesting anyway. It's just like any FPS game out there, only it's not entirely FPS, obviously. You get those point of view shots, which is pretty cool, and you get like little pop-ups of the HUD, not the hub, sorry, the HUD, H-U-D, But so much of this episode was just spent strategizing, moving from point A to point B, and watching a bunch of boring NPCs get killed instead of watching our two main characters take anyone out. I mean, truth, I get it, because at the end she pops up out of a box. I'm not sure how that works. She pops up out of like a box or something, or a crate, and like blasts away everybody. Blasts away this little team of soldiers that surrounded her, and right, they didn't know where she was, but then she surprises them and ambushes them and kills them all off, and you know, it's pretty cool looking, but it's so unbelievably boring because it's just a bunch of generic NPCs. Well, they're not NPCs, actually. Sorry, that's, I should correct myself. They're not really NPCs, they're just not characters to follow at all. They're just other players, and it's like, who do we really care? Like, who are all these people? I don't know. Who really cares, right? There's even this point where like, I don't know, you got this, she's blah, 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 blah. And I'm like, why is this person being, why am I being told this when it's already one showing me, and why it's not, it's like, he's like detailing, it's like a play-by-play practically. It's like, he's giving the play-by-play of what our character's doing, of little pink girl is doing, and it's not even, and I'm like, why are you telling me this? One, I'm already seeing it. Two, if it needs to be narrated, it should be by her. It should be her, like, internalizing. It's like, okay, fire the shot, you know? Does anybody remember Sherlock Holmes from, like, 10 years ago? The live-action Robert Downey Jr. movie where he's, like, laying out every step of his fight? That, like that, basically. That's what it should have been, but it's like some dude off-screen. I'm not even sure if it was one of the players or if it was a narrator or something. Because, you know, it's just generic, rah, 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 rah. Sorry. Oh, God. It's so dumb. It's so dumb. This whole episode was so dumb. You know, I mean, as much as I dislike the original Sword Art Online, I'll give it credit. The first couple episodes were pretty decent. I mean, the second episode was meh by that point. It dropped off really quickly for me, but the first episode was actually pretty good from the original Sword Art Online that I remember. And this was really just so uninteresting. I mean, maybe it's because I'm already going in with a negative perception because I don't like this franchise at all, but even then, it just, nothing did it for me. It was just a lot of like, we're gonna go this place, this place, this place. It was so much goddamn strategizing and watching a bunch of other player killers, jeez. I'm getting my Don Hack mixed in already. It was watching a bunch of other player characters get killed by other player characters, not by our two main characters. So why do I care? I don't know. The show wants me to care for some reason, but it's just not a good first episode. It's just not a good first impression for the rest of the series, but I'll give it a couple more episodes. I don't outright hate it right now. At least I don't think. I mean, there have been times I've said that, and then I just like, screw it, I don't want to watch anymore. But right now, this is looking like an early drop, if I don't drop it right away. Just because this episode was not good. So, another thing to report, Noyuki Kajira for the music. I'm not too surprised. You know, I'm a big fan of her, but I don't really like her Sword Art Online music either, except for Swordland. That's the one track out of the whole soundtrack that I liked. And the rest of the soundtrack was kind of boring, so... But I'm not too surprised she's not a part of this. I didn't think she would be, but you never know. So that's gonna really do it for Sword Art Online Alternative Gun Gale Online, the first and likely the first watch and likely the first drop of this season. We'll give it one more episode, but not counting on this to be another good one.